Hello my friends, in this video I'm going to tell you what we are doing as soon as we get babies from our Stoke's spiny-tailed skinks or Egernia stokesii. BION Terrarium Center has been breeding this beautiful Australian species for the last 15 years, and almost every year we get about 20 babies of these beautiful lizards. We have quite big breeding stock. Particularly in this terrarium we have one pair, so one male and one female. She is a little bit nervous. I will put her back. I have to mention that we normally don't disturb them during wintering, because now they have wintering, they have the lights switched off. We don't offer any food to them during this time, and I don't want to overheat the animal with the heat from my hands, so I released it just now. And let's get back to the topic of our video. So what do we normally do when we find a baby or babies inside the terrarium? Let's go. During all time that we have been breeding Egernia stokesii, we saw from 1 to 6 babies that are born by one female. Normally female of Egernia stokesii produces litter only once a year. For example, in our practice it is usually happening in July, but we have a female that from time to time gives us 2 litters, so one in July and the second one in October. It is sitting right here, and this female is our really proud big mama. As soon as we find a baby inside the terrarium, it usually escapes from our eyesight and hides under the rocks, under the logs or pieces of bark, and this is normal behavior for them. So what we basically do is leaving them with their parents for the first 2 or 3 days, and it is extremely important for them, because the babies need to consume some feces of their parents. The thing is that the feces of adult animals are rich in special microflora and microfauna that is essential for proper digestion of the babies. As we know that Egernia stokesii are omnivorous, and they consume quite a big amount of herbs, of plant food, they need some microbiota to digest it properly. Additionally, when the babies are kept with their parents, we always put some salad for the parents to recover from the breeding, for the female to recover her strength, and we also add some small crickets for the babies also to try to start forage on their own. Then, after 3 or 5 days that the baby spent with their parents, we move them to their so-called kindergarten terrariums that are specially prepared for each separate litter. This means that the babies from one pair or one group are put together in the terrarium. So if we have 3 babies from one female, we put them together in one terrarium. If we have 5 babies, we put them again together. And we don't mix the litters, and of course we track the feces that we sometimes transfer from the parental terrarium to the baby's terrarium. We don't mix the feces, so the litter always receive exclusively the feces from their parents, never from other animals. Of course, the hygienic terrariums are minimally equipped. We use paper instead of substrate, we use water dish, we use a special feeding dish where we place food. We use UVB lighting and heating lamp to maintain temperatures and humidity that are identical to those for adult animals, and we of course provide sufficient amount of shelters for the babies to hide. And in such conditions they spend the following 4, 5, or 6 months. After that we sort babies according to their size, because even within 1 liter the babies can grow differently. So some individuals can be dominant, they are bigger, they always get more food from the common feeding dish, and some are smaller. So to avoid the unnecessary competition for food and for space, for basking points whatsoever, we make a sorting of babies and form groups according to the sizes. After that, the babies are transferred to another terrariums, and let's see how they are organized. As soon as we got the newly reformed groups, we moved them to another terrariums, this time with substrate, with different shelters. These terrariums are usually bigger, and they spend there all their time until we are able to sex them and see what is the sex ratio within the group. Till this, they usually don't show any signs of aggression, and if they do, we readily separate the individuals that are the most aggressive or that are suppressed by other members of the group. Well, I hope that you enjoyed the video and it was useful for you. Please keep in mind that we never teach or give instructions for anybody to do anything. We are just sharing our experience and we hope that it will help somebody. So if you have other experience or other thoughts, please feel free to share it in comment section. And at now, please follow us on Facebook, subscribe to our YouTube channel, and stay safe.